Now, having said that, the next aspect, the last aspect out here, if I have to look at in this particular case, is what we look at is profitability issues. Or I will say profitability ratios. We looked at, of course, profitability ratio. Somebody can argue, what is the return on investment? Yes, return on investment is a profitability ratio. Basically, it talks about profit. There can be other forms of profitability ratios also. When I say other forms of profitability ratio, I will say, what is the return on my total assets out there? I have total assets invested, total assets out there. Or I can even say, instead of total asset, I can say return on my fixed assets out there. Why your return on fixed asset? Fixed asset is for core operation. On my investment in fixed assets out there, imagine my total capital in the company, 50 million. 30 million is in fixed asset. 20 million is basically in what is called as my investments, other investments out there. If I look at my total return on investment, it will be lower. Whereas, if I look at the return on the fixed asset, return on fixed asset will be far higher in that particular case. Because I am looking at the return, because why, what are you interested as an investor? You are interested in the core operations of the company. So, I want to look at the return on fixed assets out there. Am I with you on this? So, basically, these ratios can basically what you call it as, one can keep on devising many of these ratios out there. Let me take you through what is called as a simple Excel out there, what we basically have looked at. I am just going to increase the font size. I mean, don't copy these ratios, you don't, I am not expecting the entire thing out there. This is just to give you an idea. Yesterday somebody talked to me about credit rating, that is the word somebody used, if I am not wrong. Somebody used credit rating. How do we decide debt? Somebody said credit rating. How do you decide whether to invest in a company in the form of a debt? Somebody said credit rating immediately. So credit rating agencies basically do this kind of a stuff, because I used to work for one of them. That is all. Now what I have done? I have devised various forms of ratios out there. It is not a standard. I have looked at profitability. When I am looking at profitability, there are various aspects what I am looking at. I am looking at what is that OPBDIT? Nothing but operating profit, because I am interested in the operations of the company. I am looking, when I am say operating profit, what have I done? I have knocked out other income, I have knocked out other expenditure. I have taken only operating income. When I say operating income, that is only sales plus basically the income from the core activity, expenditure related to the core activity, recast the balance sheet and calculated the profit out there. So I am looking at operating, what is the operating profit? Before depreciation, interest and tax. Why DIT? Depreciation, non-cash expenditure, not worried. Interest, because of capital structure, not worried. Taxes, mandatory, keep it aside. So, I want to look at bare minimum, what is the kind of operation. At various levels I have done. I have looked at, I have knocked off interest, I have knocked out taxes, etc., and then done it. The same thing what I have done is, when I say return on investment out there, at the operating level, at the before the interest, after the interest, etc., out there, then debt plus tangible net worth is basically your total capital in the firm out there. So, this basic aspect what we have done in the process. I mean, you don't have to copy all this. I am not expecting this, just to give you an idea. So, what I am trying to do, textbook will give you a set of ratios. But these ratios can be devised depending on the companies what you are looking at. If you are looking at a bank, the kind of ratios what you will have to look at will be completely different compared to a manufacturing firm. If you are looking at service industry, the kind of ratios what you have to look at will be completely different out there, because these you will have to decide. That is, how do I assess the performance of the company? Performance of the company can be assessed by profitability part of it. Now, profitability, if for example, you'll imagine a company where the second aspect in the balance sheet, that is the investment, is zero. There is no investment out there other than very, very minimal or negligible part. Then looking at separating the operations part of it and the profit part of it, the operating profit and the profit, there is no return, there is not going to be not much of difference. It is basically going to be the same in the process. So it depends on the company. That is why what I want. This is basically what I did for Unilever. I was just looking at comparison. Now, if in this particular case, I will say at the operating level, compared to the previous year, this year there is an improvement. It was 16% last year. Now the return is 21%. Well, it has improved by 4% out there. Now, the analysis stops here. No, analysis only begins here. Now, why is that 4%? What is making that efficiency of 4%? That we will go ahead. That is not expected at this stage. We will worry about it as we at the later stage. At this stage, at least looking at these basic aspects, what is required for your analysis, it's all what is basically required in the process. If I have to move ahead further, I looked at the capitalization, the debt equity. You will say debt by tangible net worth, basically debt equity part of it, how does it vary, what are the kind of aspects, how does it vary, etc. Then we looked at interest coverage ratios in the, I talked about interest coverage ratio, that is interest and finance charges, how does it compare with operating profit before depreciation, after depreciation, after interest, various combinations, that's all. I have just arrived at what you call it as basically various combinations out there, and total debt service coverage, I talked about in the last class out there, debt service coverage. In the process out there, and then I also ratios out here, your current ratio and quick ratio and so on and so forth out there. Don't worry about so many ratios out there as of now. That is only an indicator. That is why we are not going in a structured fashion, because it varies from the industry to industry and the sector at which you are looking at. So that is one of the reasons I have not gone in for a very structured approach in this. This is basically to give you an idea, and I will put up what is called as your slides out there in the on Moodle, which you can basically use it. Now I'll coming back to this in the process. Now the next aspect, when we look at basically the profitability part of it, we looked at next aspect. What we look at is we look at in the liquidity part of it itself. We sort of look at out here. Yeah, in the liquidity part of it itself, when we look at the other two aspects, what we looked at in the last class. Now, the days payable and what we call it as days receivable. That is, on an average, how long do you take to pay? On an average, how long do you take to receive the money? That will also talk about your liquidity part of it. Why? Because if you are taking more time to receive and more time to pay, then what happens? Your company is illiquid. If the time is sort of matching, that is the number of days you take to pay and the number of days you take to what is called as receive is almost the same, then your liquidity is taken care. Or if it is like Amazon, where you pay first, whereas they pay after about 200 days, then what happens? Your company is highly liquid. You have a problem of too much of cash flows out there. Because please note, idle cash does not mean anything. Cash has to give you return. Cash in the cash box does not mean anything in the process. So they have to find avenues to invest, which will keep on giving you return in the process out there. Am I with you in all those things? Now, if it is 200 days, then what is the problem in Amazon? Please understand. Because I know that you will pay me only after 200 days when I sell the goods to you, the markup what I am going to have will always be far higher compared to, because if you do a cash down purchase, the price will be lower. If it is going to be higher credit period, then the markup will always be slightly higher in the process out there. So somewhere or the other, it basically gets evened out. So what when we talk about ratios out there, you can look at various forms of ratios out there. Somebody can even look at how long does the inventory stay in my company out there. I can even look at what you call it as the number of days, that is inventory turnover ratio. How long does the inventory stay? Simple. I will say, what is the average stock of raw material? Let me say, the average stock of raw material in my company is, let us say, 10 lakhs. What is the amount of raw material consumed through the year in my company? What is the time of raw material consumed through the year in the company? Imagine the kind of raw material that is consumed through the year in my company is about, say, about 500 lakhs out there. That means on an average, how many days raw material do you keep? 500 is what is consumed through the year. Divide by your 365, you know what is the consumption per day. You know what is the stock what you are basically keeping. You know what is the number of times it is getting turned over out there. That is all. All this will talk about what you call it as efficiency in the company. Too much of raw material out there, then too much of money basically blocked out there. Less of raw material, then less of money blocked basically out there in the process. So basically these ratios, what we sort of look at, these ratios one can basically decide. When I talk about the liquidity, I talk about, I think this is the first time I am using slides in the class. Anyway, when we talk about ratios out there, we can talk about liquidity, I can talk about current assets, current liabilities, quick assets like quick liabilities, etc. Then I can look at the leverage, or we call it capitalization ratios, we talk it leverage ratio. Leverage means what? The company is highly levered. That is the word many times you would use in the C in the context. Levered means what? Highly debt out there, very high debt component. Levered means more and more debt in the company. That is what we call it as leverage. I look at debt issue and what portion of the debt is the asset. I look at the interest coverage. These are the basics of what we are looking at. Further, I can even look at what is the kind of inventory turnover out there. Imagine what is the average inventory, what is the sales out there. What is the account receivable out there in the process? What are the fixed assets? What is the total assets? What is the kind of turnover? You can devise many of these kind of things out there. I can look at the profitability, return on total asset, earning power, that is, and then return on equity, and so on and so forth, and then basically keep going on in the process out there. Now, I will put up on Moodle some rough, what do you call it as, slides with some ratios out there. Don't ask me after that. The ratios what you have put up, I will exactly calculate all the ratios what you have put up. Now I should get maximum marks. Need not. That is only indicative. You will have to look at it based on your company and look at, use your own imagination, use your own thinking, use your own logic to basically, that is fine. That is indicative. You can add more, and all of it may not even be relevant. So you might have to delete more, some also from that particular list out. Pick up any textbook, it is there. Now, one thing you need to avoid. I will just go to moneycontrol.com, and I will type the name of the company. P&L will be there, balance sheet will be there, ratios will be there. I will cut and paste in the Excel sheet and dump it to you. No, don't do that. Reason. And how can you find out? I can find out. I will also tell you how I can find out. Because money control, what you find, the P&L and balance sheet will be adjusted P&L and balance sheet. The ratios what he has calculated and put up out there in money control, if you actually pick up the figures, what is called as from the annual report and calculate, you will never get that figure. You will never get that figure. So I can easily make out. So please don't. Adjusted in the sense, what happens is grouping. When we say in this particular case itself, what is adjusting? I'll come to what is adjusting out here. We saw this Excel out here. For example, in this particular case, I have said what is material cost, what is traded goods purchased, etc. for the company what I have calculated. Now, I do what is called as classification further in the process. Let me just go down a little bit. Now, what constitutes gross sale, what constitutes this thing, what all constitutes other related income. So what happened? What am I doing? I am looking at the schedules of these companies, regrouping them. I am looking at regrouping all that basically schedule, the annual report I will take, I will regroup. What the company has claimed as a related income, according to me as an analyst, is not a related income. I will take it out of that and I will put it somewhere else. I will put it in what is called as other, it will not a related, it will be putting it as unrelated income. These are the kind of adjustments. So what I do, we basically keep on doing what is called as classification out there. Now I will say, manufacturing related cost will be power, fuel oil, water and steam. This is what I am looking at is basically for a sugar mill, basically what we are looking at for sugar mill, etc. Now, when I am looking at, so what happens, if you look at the operating costs, they would be listing out separately. Now, when I am analyzing for a sugar mill, I am segregating these costs into different brackets out there and regrouping them in the process. That is what we call it as adjusted. And when we adjust it like that, the ratios what you calculate will be very different. And at this stage, I don't expect you guys to regroup and do that calculation. Not necessary. We will sort of look at it as we go along. This is only an idea. The reason behind the project is, the easier reason, some way for you to score at least 30, comfortably score the 30% part of it. Okay, that is a one part of it. Let us ignore that part of it. The other major part of it, the major reason. Bottom line, when I started this course, as I indicated, objective of this course is somebody gives you an annual report. You are not averse to it. You are not scared of an annual report out there. You should be comfortable holding the financial pages of the annual report and looking at it and make yourself a little more, at least you should pose yourself as you are very confident the chartered accountant will run away the other side. Right? So this is what is going to give you that kind of confidence. Whatever you have learnt is fine. We have sort of spent a lot of time and everything. Now when you actually hold the annual reports out there, if you can get a physical copy, well and good. I mean, ideally, if you want to pick up a company from the list, away from the outside the list what I have provided, still perfectly fine. It's still perfectly fine. I'm going to give you. See, you can even pick up your own company because you will even get a hard copy of your annual report out there. So pick up that, and basically what you do is when you read those numbers, when you read those schedules, when you calculate the ratios, etc., somebody says, oh, the liquidity of the position is very bad, immediate will strike. What did you calculate for liquidity? You looked at current ratios out there. So that way you will be able to relate better, you will be able to sit a little more confidently and have a conversation with the CFO or whatever who comes and talks to you. That is the basic objective. And this is what is going to give you that confidence, not whatever 10 weeks what you have spent.